What's up, guys? Commander Alex here, and today I have a little vainglory for you. So I was looking over at my screen over there. But anyway, moving on with the video here, we're just gonna hop in and play a practice match. I don't want to get into public quite yet because I do want to know what I'm doing before I do that. But we can still play a practice match right here, and it looks like we're gonna pick Ringo because he's kind of the character that I've had the most luck with so far. I've also really been enjoying Saw, but I think that Saw is a lot better in multiplayer just because he has a lot of burst damage. So if you get like a flank on somebody, he can power him down really, really quickly. But anyway, we're talking about Ringo today. So first buys that I'm gonna do with him are probably gonna be some attack speed, which is gonna be the Swift Shooter, and then I'm also going to want to upgrade my Achilles heel ability. I'm not sure if I upgraded my Achilles heel ability first or second, but that's probably one of the most important ones with him because I like using Ringo as a sort of jungle unit. So in this video, I did say mostly the lane just because there is not an enemy hero when you're doing practice rounds, so it's not really a worry about having to get boost or to steal like advanced minions or something. But later, when you're playing multiplayer, it's actually really useful to go into the jungle, pick up some extra gold, and then also pick up some different buffs and minion boosts. Another thing is, if you stay in the jungle long enough and the game progresses long enough, you can actually get the, I think it's not the Titan, something around that name, but basically it's this giant Colossus that comes out of the gold mine and it just wrecks everybody. So if you guys can get that, it's probably going to be a win for you guys. Even if he doesn't actually manage to take out the crystal, they're probably going to be low enough on turrets and on crystal health that you can finish it off yourselves. So right there, I am going to get level 2, so I'm going to get my Achilles heal ability, and to do that, we're just going to target the turret, and hopefully we can at least power down this first turret fairly quickly. Looks like we're going to have to back away, but I can still pick up a little bit of gold by using my attack speed ability right there. So really, with this first wave, I'm just going to try and drop all of my different abilities as quickly as possible and clear waves as quickly as possible. So right here, I'm gonna clear out that final minion. It looks like it's not quite gonna go down, so I'm gonna have to turn right here, pick up that 42 gold, and now we can continue to hold this wave and hopefully push that turret. Now I want to talk about what you guys might want to be building on Ringo. Obviously, I'm a little bit of a noob in the game. I have played League of Legends, so I have a pretty good idea, but I'm not gonna make any exact like calls on what you guys are gonna want to buy and in what order because it's different in every game, especially because in this game there's a jungle but there's only one lane, so it's like a mix between Arma and regular League of Legends. So that sort of adds the element of, do you want to get like some jungle abilities or do you just want to stick to lane? And personally, I like going into the jungle in multiplayer matches just because I think that when you go into the jungle, you really actually help the lane more than if you were to just sit in the lane and farm. Because what happens is you can pick up minion boosts, which are actually going to allow your minions to push all the way to the enemy turret and do some serious damage. I know in a few of my games, I actually managed to get some turrets down by just getting minion boosts, and then the minions cleaned up the enemy's turrets. So it's really important to get those. And then also there's the gold mine that you get, and I think it's 10 minutes, it might be 5 minutes, I'm not quite sure how long it takes for mining to start, but once mining does start, you guys can actually get the gold mine, which is going to be 300 gold for your whole team. So if you're playing with a 3v3, that's going to be 900 gold in all, and it's really, really useful. So I like going into the jungle early. So what I do is I pick up a health regen unit, or not unit, health regen ability, or something that has to do with health regen, just because what happens is your unit's going to get really low the more you stay in the jungle because your just base health regen is not a ton and the jungle actually hits pretty hard. So you're going to want to pick up that health regen so you can sustain in the jungle and not have to back, because every time you back, you're really just giving your enemy more time to farm that you're not there. So I like picking up that health regen, and then from there I usually go and build my crystal abilities. I'm going to work on getting the crystal cooldown down, and then I'm also going to work on getting the crystal power up. You're also probably going to want to buy, I think it's called like a crystal battery or something along those lines. Basically, that's just going to give you more power or not more power, but more energy that you can use to put into your abilities, so you don't have to worry about accidentally running out of power, which you can see is what's happening on my screen right now. So that's sort of what I normally build in multiplayer. Right here, I'm probably just going to stay in lane for most of this game, because there's really no point for me to try and get that boost in the jungle, because there's no enemy heroes, which I found kind of interesting that there aren't any enemy heroes even in the practice version of this game. I would have assumed that they would just be like computer generated heroes, and they play pretty easy on you, sort of like bots would, but it looks like that's not going to be the case, and you're actually just going to have to play against minions, which is kind of an auto win for you. You could not do anything and you would automatically win the game, because minions versus minions always ends in a draw. You guys didn't know that. But moving on here, we're just gonna pop some abilities. It looks like we've done some good damage to that turret, but it still has a lot left. So I'm gonna upgrade my ultimate, and we can try that out in a few seconds once I get the energy. So this was recorded a few days ago. I was a little bit more of a noob in the game then. Obviously, I'm still a pretty big noob in the game, but I have learned a few things. The energy in this game goes quite quickly, so picking up some sort of energy regen is really, really useful, and I'd probably say it's one of the top three things you should get on any hero, as long as they really do like burst damage. But you see right here, instead of going for that energy, I'm actually going to go for the clockwork. So that's not only going to give me energy, it'll give me crystal power, energy recharge, and a cooldown acceleration. So that's pretty much all the different three things that I really talked about with the crystal and the crystal abilities. So if you get that, I'd probably say that you're set for crystal abilities, and then you can move on to damage and defense, and then obviously some utility with speed and healing. So right here, I'm also going to get the Blazing Salvo. That's going to give me a lot of attack speed, 35 in fact. And if you guys don't know, attack speed on ranged heroes like this is kind of important, because he doesn't have that much base damage. So by increasing his attack speed, you're really going to help out bursting down enemies, which is sort of how I play Rengar. Or Ringo, not Rengar. But if you guys play him a little bit differently, obviously your strategy is going to be a little bit different from mine. So it looks like the turret right here is at about half health. We do have our ultimate up, so we're going to try that out eventually here. It's a little bit interesting ultimate, because it takes a while to charge up. So what I like doing with Ringo's ultimate is actually targeting a person while I'm in a bush, and then obviously pressing the ultimate, and what that means is that I can charge up and get the ultimate going before I actually have to reveal myself to the enemy. So what happens is I will basically just pop the ultimate and allow it to do its like little swirly motion. You'll see here in a little bit when I pop my ultimate, but right here you see it's like a little I guess you would call it like a fireball or whatever that rings around your body until it shoots out. And it takes a little while to go around your body. So you have to just probably keep that in mind when you're using it. And it's not that great up close in quarters, because what happens is you get bursted down before it actually gets off. So at this point, you know, we're level 7. I really don't think that there's any chance of us not taking this turret in the next few waves, because we have a lot of burst damage, and I think that we can at least get it down to half before we have to back here. So I would probably go for a minion boost right now if I was playing this right now, but the issue was I played this in the past, so I didn't really know about the jungle. I was kind of afraid of it, and I read some articles about it, watched some videos about it, and I know a lot more about it now. It's pretty much the same thing as League of Legends jungle. It has the two minion boosts, which are those mines on the bottom left and bottom right hand side, and then it's also going to have the big gold mine in the center, which is a lot of damage to take and a lot of gold to take as well. So if you guys can team down that gold mine pretty quickly, I definitely suggest doing that, but be careful, because you can steal the gold mine, just like you can steal Baron or steal Dragon in League of Legends. So there's a few other enemy camps and ally camps in the jungle that are basically, some of them provide boosts, some of them are just gold, but they're all pretty easy to take down once you get, I'd say, past level 3. At that point, you can take them out without taking too much damage, and you can run through the jungle pretty quickly and collect a good deal of loot before you have to go into lane and actually attack enemies. So you see right here, we're going to get that turret down super, super low, but it looks like we're not actually going to be able to take it out. So I'm just going to pop my ability right here, clear this wave nice and quickly, and we can move on and hopefully take down this turret on this push. So you see the turrets are going to be auto-attacked right here. I'm really waiting for my abilities to come up, but it looks like they're just going to be down at the wrong time, and I'm going to have to take this out with an auto-attack. I popped my ability right there to focus it down, and we're going to pick up 300 gold from that. So I'm also going to clear this wave pretty quickly since I have my ability up, and we can obviously move on to the next turret. So at this point, I have over 300,000 gold, so I should probably go back and spend some of that. But I think my minions are going to be fine. And to finish off our build here, it looks like we're going to have to work towards the Sorrow Blade. So that's going to be something that you're really going to want to get when you're using most heroes. Obviously there's some that don't work with it, but for the most part, I'd say getting the Sorrow Blade is amazing because it's just a ton of pure damage. It's not really complicated like a lot of the defensive things that you can buy. It's really simple, you know, it just boosts your damage and it really helps you to power down enemies. So right here, I'm just looking at what I want to buy. I'm looking around and I think I'm actually going to go maybe for the chronograph. I don't actually know what I'm gonna go for. Guess I'm just gonna hop around here, and then I'm gonna take the piercing shard, and that's just gonna give me better cooldown time, so I won't have to wait quite as long. Because I'd say that the cooldowns for this aren't insane like in League of Legends. You get an ultimate that takes, I don't know, like 80 some seconds to cool down, and it's really only useful for initiating team fights and for defending team fights, but it's not really useful in any other, you know, sort of like minion clearing sort of aspects. But with this game, you know, your different abilities come up pretty quickly, and they're really useful for clearing minion waves because they don't take a ton of energy once you have your energy regen different builds. I don't know why I can't talk today. But we're going to upgrade our Achilles here right there, and we're also going to clear out this wave. It looks like there's a bunch of shooting minions in the back, but they're really low health, so we can take those out pretty easily and hopefully steal a good bit of gold in the process. So now at this point, you can see we have our first turret down. We're level 10, and we're just going to keep pushing because there's nothing that could stop us at this point. We're rolling, and I think we can take this wave pretty easily. So the wave went down really easily. There's still two of my minions left, and there's a new wave coming in. So I'm just going to sit here and just keep auto-attacking this turret, which is already taking quite a bit of damage. So I'm going to sit there, probably get it down to about a third, and then I'm going to have to back away because my minions are going to go down pretty quickly. So it looks like it's gotten below a third, maybe at about a half, but I am going to have to back up because my minions are now all dead, and I don't want to get attacked by that turret. So right here, we're just going to auto-attack the minions, take them out really, really quickly, and now we can upgrade our attack speed ability. So we can pop that, and it looks like we're just going to focus down this turret with ease. There's going to be an issue where what happens is when the enemy goes in the jungle and takes two minion camps, not minion camps, takes two minion boost camps, basically what happens is their minions become stronger than you can take them out, and even though you can obviously clear the wave, you can't clear it fast enough, and it basically stalls even if you have a hero in lane. So really never let their minions get stronger than yours. You can obviously trade one minion boost camp for another minion boost camp, but I wouldn't go and allow them to take both of your camps. So right here, we're just going to take down that turret. That went down pretty easily. We're now at 2,000 gold, so I should probably be backing pretty soon. But it looks like I do want to clear out this wave, which is probably pretty smart because once I clear out this wave, I'm just going to keep having my minions attack the turret right here. So I'm going to pop my attack speed ability, and we're going to focus down that turret to about one or two-thirds of its health. So now we can go back to base with 2,300 gold and spend that on, well, let's see what we spend it on. It's kind of hard commentating on this game because I don't know what's going to happen. It's not like a lot of the games that I play where I'm pretty sure what I would do in that situation. Since I'm learning so quickly in this game about different aspects of it, it's really different each time I play it, so I can't really predict what I'm going to do in the game. But it looks like we do have a new upgrade, and we can actually upgrade our ultimate, so we're going to do that, get that to level 3, and having a level 3 ultimate is very, very useful. And this, obviously, we can just wreck any minion wave, but even in a normal game, having a level 3 ultimate really does a lot of damage. I'd say that for the most part, having a level 3 ultimate will take most enemy heroes' health down to about half, and then if you have good auto attack abilities and other good sort of builds, you can probably take out that enemy hero pretty easily. So at this point, it looks like my minions are holding at that turret pretty easily. There's still about 5 of them left, and I think that we can clear the wave and allow them to get at that turret. So I just popped my attack speed ability right there. I'm going to clear that wave nice and easily, send in our ultimate, which is going to do a ton of damage, as well as our Achilles heal ability. We should probably pop our attack speed ability right about now, but it looks like we don't need that. We're just going to focus on the turret and take it out to get 300 gold. So now we're just going to finish off this guy. It looks like he's going to have 2 turrets left in here. But that's not going to be much of an issue because we can just sit in here and farm this guy's minions until my new minions come in. So sorry about that notification. My dad's a writer, and he's really on Goodreads all that all the time. But this is his iPad, so kind of have to deal with it. Anyway, we're going to focus down this right-hand turret. It looks like it's going to focus on the minions, and we're going to be able to get it down to about half health. It's going to get one shot off at me, but I have a lot of health regen as well as just a lot of health in general, so I don't really think that I'm going to have an issue with that. Now I pop my attack speed ability right there so I can clear this wave with ease, and now my minions are going to have a straight shot at the bottom left-hand turret. So I'm going to start attacking the top right-hand turret, just because if we take them both out, it's just going to be a lot easier to take down that crystal. So right here, the turret's going to go down, his minions are going to spawn. I'm going to pop, I guess I didn't pop an ability, but that's okay because we can take it out with just auto attacks, and now we can wait around for our next wave. So this is basically what the end of the game is going to be for you guys, whether you're playing multiplayer or practice. Once you take out everything but those inner turrets, it's basically just camping inside and waiting for your next wave to come in. And you can also actually attack people from spawn. Now there is like a little zone where you can attack them, but they get like crazy health regen, so I wouldn't suggest doing it. But if you guys like are chasing someone and they're already low health and then you want to finish them off, you can actually go in and take people out who are inside of their spawn area. So there's really no place to hide in this game. You don't get like a little safe zone where you spawn. But at this point, you know, the crystal's going to go down pretty easily, and I think that's going to be pretty much game for this. So thank you for watching. Remember to like, comment, and subscribe. Become a lieutenant today, and tell me what you thought of this so I can obviously adjust my gameplay in the future. So see you guys, and I'll see you next time.